Let me tell it. So she was like, look, I ain't gonna keep telling you that I gotta be at work. And I'm on my last half point. I'm gonna get fired and this motherfucking light bill due. You should have thought about that before you got the other points. So when she heard that and she knew that the kids need lights and Jeffrey didn't care, she was shitty. She hopped up. She ain't put on no tennis shoes. She put on her fucking house shoes. She walked down the street. And she got the car. And he said, what you doing? What you doing, Candy? Because he's showing off for his friends. Mm-hmm. I ain't be showing off for them niggas in front of me. I ain't showing off. I always talk like this to you. Go do your hair. Don't be coming out here like that. And that was the final straw. That was the final straw. Yeah. Where your friend at, Tramella?
No, Tramella.
And she didn't know Tramella, but this is our story. So look. Candy got in that motherfucking car. And she looked at that shit. And it was almost on E. And when he left the night before, it was on full. And she like, you wasted a whole type full shank. And it was just no gas to do one thing, either get home or kill that nigga. And she said, I'm going to try to kill this nigga because women are logical. And she could have just went home and slept it off. So she tried to run the nigga over. But the tires, he had a donut on that motherfucker. Yeah. So it didn't make it up on the curve. It didn't make it on the curve.
It was made on the curve.
So look, okay, y'all story was better than
so
mine.
So look, when she went real fast, it was a little ass Chevette. She went real fast, but it had no horsepower. So she hit the curve real hard, and she hit her head, and she woke up in Indiana. That's the story.
Your story was better than me.
That's a way better movie, because it's a comedy, it's a drama, and then Madea came from behind the corner and beat him with a hammer. Madea came.
Fight, baby.
Oh, my gosh. We did some crazy shit. That relationship was crazy.
What was the craziest thing about that relationship?
I thought one of us was going to die. One of us is gonna have to die to get out of that relationship. What was the craziest thing? Shit, there's so many. Like,
okay, we just want one. We don't want.
I just gave you one.
What? We were gonna die.
To run the motherfucker.
Okay, that was boring. We want the next best one. Because if that was the best, your relationship wasn't shit like Argentina.
When he jumped on me.
He jumped out the bushes. What was you doing in the bushes?
I know somebody else.
I wasn't in the bushes. He was in the bushes.
What was he doing in the bushes?
Wait for me.
Wait for you. Whose house was you coming out? When was you wiping off your lips? I want the whole story. I want the whole story.
All eyes on you.
Damn it, man. Okay. So I was trying to leave his crazy ass because he was crazy.
Where you going?
It was a domestic violence relationship.
Where you going?
Period. So I was actually about to leave and go out of town. Shit didn't work out. So I go back to a friend's house.
God, female.
Male.
It was actually like a grandma's house. You know how you go to
come on,
house.
It was a nigga over the grandma's house.
You didn't go to grandma's
house.
You didn't go to grandma's house.
We stopped over there. We stopped over there. And
the club.
It was Miss Thompson's house. If you really want to know, it was Miss Thompson's house.
So shout out Miss Thompson. If you still around running them hoes out there, let me know.
Cut your bushes.
So going out of there is his. Because I'm with his people, because of where I was living at. I was with his
okay,
people.
You was homeless. Okay, now I'm just finishing.
I wasn't homeless. Anyway, I go over there. I'm walking in the house, and all of a sudden, this nigga jump out the bushes. And his friends saw. They were like, oh, you is actually fucking crazy, motherfucker. You jumping out of bushes on bitches? Like, and he started.
What'd he say when he jumped out of the bush?
What'd he say?
Yeah, that weak-ass story.
What'd he say? Rah, boo, gotcha.
I knew it, bitch. What'd he say?
Did he jump out on accident because a bug was on
him? He didn't say nothing.
So he just hopped out the bush.
That's like Michael Myers.
He just hopped out
the
bush.
He just hopped out the bush.
Just breathing hard. Like a crazy motherfucker.
Did he fight the other nigga?
Yeah.
No, he didn't fight him. What he did.
So it was another guy.
See, what? You got to bring it out.
No, it wasn't no other nigga.
His friend.
It's such a long story. Like, I got to go back. That's why I'm like.
Okay, it's official. You tell shitty stories.
Okay, fine.
We're going to have to. You know, next weekend, you come back with a lie. Matter of fact, tell somebody else's story.
I'm going to come back with the truth. I'm going to just put it out.
Tell me your best story. Lie or not.
Best story.
My best story?
Yeah.
Let me see. Best. You want a relationship one? I'll give you a relationship one.
You can talk about the first time you fucking cross street. It's going to be more interesting than that
you
bullshit.
Because
right,
I said, ouch.
That's horrible.
Yeah, it was horrible.
That's rude.
What's rude?
I'm going to be silent for the candy out.
Yeah, I'm we just trying to. We no, trying to
candy come
you
back.
Story
how to
candy
tell
come
stories.
In.
That's no way to
it's
be about.
It's too long and drawn out. It's complicated. You feel like you got to start from the beginning.
You can take a
domestic violence relationship is like.
okay, I'm
gonna. It'd be funny as shit when you ain't in them.
I'm gonna give you.
I'd have heard some funny ass shit about when you're ass
whooped. I thought it was funny.
Me and my baby mama, we got into it to the point where I didn't hit her, but I mushed her. But this how it went down. I get off work. I get off. I don't work hard. I come in. I'm like, hey, bitch, I'm about to go play basketball. And she said, okay. I'm like, I'm going to the store too. So I get back. I get home.
I was shit in the front porch.
I get shit in the yard. I've been jailed. That would have happened. I've been jailed. That would happen.
Oh boy, I've done that.
I come home. She got mad because I went and played ball. So I'm like, you only mad for me playing ball. You should got mad for me calling you a bitch. So we going back and forth.
I been a bitch, but that basketball shit gotta go.
So
you think it's James Nate Smith?
She all in my face, and she a midget, right? So I'm like, I didn't want to hit her, but then I did. But I'm like, no, I ain't gonna hit her. So you probably don't watch wrestling. So I chokeslammed her. Like, I picked her up like the Big Show. You don't watch wrestling?
Yeah, I grabbed her.
I put my hand on her back. I put my hand around her neck. And I picked her up, but I talked to her as I was lifting. I was like, you see what I can do? This shit's real.
You learning your lesson up there? Huh? Have you learned your lesson up there?
But I didn't really want to hurt her, so I kind of laid her down. Like, it was real gentle and soft. I laid her down, and I caressed her hair.
Okay, baby boy.
Yeah, but then, you know what was fucked up about that whole situation? We did get into it.
Y'all lost the basketball game?
I did choke her and shit. But it went to the point where it was like, I'm going to call the police.
She called screw.
No, you stupid. It was a spider on the wall. I was upset, so I went to kill it. And I put a hole in the wall. You know the first thing I was thinking?
She going to say I did this because of her.
She called the police. I'm going to jail because of a fucking spider. You know how quick I ran to Home Depot? I patched that mug up. And it was the ugliest patch job ever. I'm talking about it was so thick and the shit was glumped up. Glooped up a word. Gloop. Is it gloop?
I don't know the difference between curb and curb. So, you know my words.
Well, I was using a word that too many people don't use. You was using a word people use on a daily basis.
Yeah, curbs and shit.
Curbs. Curbs.
Look at the curbs on that girl. She's so thick. Look at the curbs on her. Look at her hips.
I don't talk about girl, curbs.
You got curbs. You got curbs.
You got curbs, curbs. Not curbs.
Curbs.
Whatever.
Curbs.
Whatever.
Curbs.
Say it again. Say curbs.
I got a lot of stories. He got his teeth knocked out from running from the police.
Oh, Kirk should have told that story.
I just thought about
that's
it.
That's all she's going to say. And then he got his teeth knocked out.
That's why she here.
And what else?
She got his teeth knocked out. She got warrants and he locked up and he coming for her. And you going to pick. You going to pick
call him right now and be like, remember when?
Remember when he jumped out the bushes?
Do it.
Hold on. Get that nigga on speaker. Get that nigga on speaker. Get him on speaker. Hold on. Get him on speaker.
While we here, you do that on the chat where he can go to your house and kill you because it's five other people up here. And if he come and shoot, he going to miss you. He going to hit one of us. And my shirt is new.
He ain't that crazy.
I don't want no blood on my shirt.
About that life.
Go ahead, call him real quick. He ain't about to lie.
He's gonna think you in town about giving some.
Dang.
I'm pretty sure he remembers he ain't got no fucking teeth.
He still got no teeth.
You was fucking with a toothless nigga.
I should ask him, did he ever get his teeth?
I hate if I had no insurance. Because if I lose my two front teeth, even one, I'm not going nowhere until I go get that porcelain.
All you gotta do is get a what's name?
What?
Go to the mall, get some golds, they can brace it.
That's what he did.
Yeah.
No, I need some real shit.
I'm talking about until you get the real.
I'm not going nowhere until I get some real shit.
You go to the mall.
What's some real fake shit?
You get some. And it'll cover the
front. Man, I'm not in Wu-Tang Clan. I'm not in the Wu-Tang Clan.
That's exactly
go on with a gold grill.
That's why gold teeth ain't good for you.
Well, how come?
Because clearly under it wasn't healthy.
That's because he had that cheap shit.
Yeah.
You got to take care of yourself. You can't just put on a shirt and think you ain't going to get dirty. You still got to take a shower. Shit.
Hell no.
Yeah, I'm for sure you didn't brush your teeth when you was in the bushes.
Hey, who is the guy we calling? Who we calling?
He can't find his number.
You ain't calling him? Aww. Cause she made that shit up.
Mm-hmm.
She made that shit up.
Hey, I'm about to take.
Hey, we about to take this quick break. We gonna come right back. Holler at y'all. Mm-hmm.
face, sucker nigga, wherever you are. I thought about you, fool, while I was driving my car. I wonder if you fools realize how far you are. You know where in my rear mirror. Shit ain't better than my first shit, huh? Your best shit ain't better than my worst shit, huh? The truth in my verses, verses. Your metaphors about what your net worth is.
And we're back live with the show.
And then he was running from the police, and then he got hit in the mouth, and they fell down, and they was gold.
He ran
and
into a tree, and knocked his teeth
out. He ran into the tree.
Georgia the Jungle. It was. That nigga was straight the fuck up. They was about to lock
was he drunk?
Up.
You
no,
fuck with a dummy.
So, somebody called the police who was out there arguing, and they was about to lock him up, and he was literally like in the handcuffs, and he just like, man, fuck this shit, and just ran. That shit was kind of funny.
That's been there for a while.
I mean, he dipped into the neighborhood, so that's even worse.
I know, but I could see if you would have said he crossed the street and a car came out of nowhere. I don't know where he ran on.
That nigga was gone. You hear me? Like, that shit was like, whoa. This nigga ran. I didn't know you could run like that.
He ran mouth first into a tree.
I think it was a tree. I gotta ask.
Oh, man. He ran mouth first into a tree. Y'all never gonna catch me. Y'all never gonna catch me, pal. Yeah. Can y'all at least get my gold out the tree? Did you ever find his gold?
I don't know. We went and he went and got some shit.
He put some gold in her. He still ain't got no teeth?
That's what I need to ask him. Did you ever get your teeth fixed?
Is that your baby daddy? Or?
No comment.
That's hereditary.
What's hereditary?
Your kids gonna lose their teeth?
He had golds in his teeth.
They gonna lose their teeth because... Did he have his teeth when you got pregnant or after? If he didn't have no teeth while he was hitting you, and you got pregnant, your kids' front teeth gonna be fucked up. They gonna be walking around. They gonna be walking around with them big ass gold caps, bad as fuck.
I'm so done.
When they walk around trees, do they seem like they get fidgety and nervous and shit?
This is why I tell y'all shit.
No, shit. These are facts. These are facts.
No damn facts.
You ain't never seen nobody. You ain't never seen nobody have a scar. Have a scar. Then they get somebody pregnant and they child had something like that scar there, like they lip be fucked up or some shit like that.
No, the birthmark.
See? If she's seen it, it's real true. Yeah, it's real true.
You ain't never seen that?
Yeah. It's real true. Man, I know my kids got some traits that I ain't even think can get passed down, but.
Like what? Nipples.
Hold on, man. You child molested the brain having motherfucker. Kids don't got nipples, you faggot. They come in adulthood. Shit.
They go at 14.
Yeah.
What traits?
Just like personality traits.
That's fucked up. Hold on, though. That's fucked up, though. Because my daughter, man, she got a real bad attitude. And I mentioned, I'm like, man, Chi-Chi got an attitude. And they're like, oh, wonder where she gets that from. Yeah. And they always say it like that. And they say, like, wonder where she gets that from.
Where she get it from?
I have no fucking idea.
Because
when I was a baby, when I was that age, man, I was cool. When I was a kid, I was cool.
Yeah.
I was nice.
You didn't have it when you was a baby.
Did you ever notice how you act when you was pregnant, your children?
I've never been pregnant.
I'm talking to the only one that can have children.
I wasn't pregnant.
Well, technically, y'all can have children. She's the only one that could carry.
Whatever.
Boom.
I didn't know. Well, no, because I was like weird when I was pregnant.
Yeah, that's smart,
man. I mean, I was emotional, but... My kids didn't turn out to be too emotional, I guess.
I'm glad you said that. Cause
they act like they're dead. They don't act like that. I hate it with a passion.
Let me ask you something. Yeah, why do females do that? Like, why do they hate when their kids act like...
You act just like your dad.
Because it's not the good traits. It be the bad traits. Like, my youngest son, he's real sneaky. Like, real, real sneaky. Like, he would walk past, he would take something from the kitchen and hold it behind his back and walk real slow.
That's how your daddy was hiding them bitches. That's how your daddy was hiding them bitches.
I saw you the whole time, dude.
He got caught?
Yeah, he always get caught.
Okay, then as a parent, that's
like you're sneaky.
You trained him not to get caught. You got to steal. This is what
look,
you
baby.
Do.
Yeah. You got to be more thorough in your thieving. Like, I see you like stealing. So this is how we're going to do it.
We're going to practice. That Tuesday, we're going to practice.
Because
if it was a good choice,
I need a bra.